Welcome to the Innovation Coffee Break, today with an important topic from the field of electromobility and electric drives, the test of high-voltage traction inverters. Let me show you. So what is this for? When we think about an electric vehicle, the powertrain consists of three major components: the battery, the motor, and the inverter. Of course, we can test an inverter in the real car, but we will show you that our simulation-based approach has some striking advantages. The system here serves this purpose. Let me show you. We have connected the inverter here as in the battery electric vehicle. So we are handling the battery voltage, the real high voltage, and the motor currents, the real motor currents, as in the electric drive. Also, we're taking care of all other interfaces from this device under test, which is here water cooling and sensor interfaces. Now, I want to take you to a test drive. All safe. Now we are in the simulated environment. So let's switch on our electric car. Starts a maneuver. And now we're driving. The simulated environment has the advantage that we can vary the motor parameter via a mouse click. But our system can also simulate the whole powertrain with the battery and adjacent drives. Also, we can simulate all kinds of failure injections, and we can reproduce the tests at any time, all with the goal to release fail-safe, faultless, and energy-efficient electric components. And we test here in a simulated environment, but with real currents. So let me show you. So we have connected a power analyzer to our system. So you can see here now the power that is measured, as well as the motor currents that are currently generated by our system. Of course, we could also investigate some certain operating points in more detail. For this, we stop our maneuver here and then switch off our electric car. And then go to a different layout where we can now apply, for example, the desired test voltage. So 600 should be sufficient. We enable the drive, put torque to the system, and speed up. So in this way, I can basically investigate any operating point as I like. You can see here now the D and Q currents, the Q currents here and the D current. And as the speed increases, we see that the D current is also decreasing because our traction inverter is going into field weakening. You can also have a look now on our power analyzer, where you can see the measured currents. But we also have the currents here in our system as well. So if we go now to our scope here and take a shot, we can see very precise measurement of the currents, and also we can investigate them and see if something strange has happened here. Looking good. So how do we achieve this? For this, we want to take a closer look on our system. For this, I will deactivate this now. Deactivate the torque. Slow down the machine. It takes too long. We can speed this up here. Disable our bridges. And switch off. So now let's take a look behind the scenes. To build such systems, we have developed an electronic load module that operates as a current sink. And as it is modular, we can basically apply any configuration to it. For example, as we showed here today, we have simulated a three-phase drive and a battery. But we can vary this to simulate multiple drives, multiple batteries, and to adapt in this case for different electronic components. So we could also build systems for DC-DC converters and even grid applications. Also, the power of the system is scalable, so we could use less modules to build small systems, or we can use many modules to build large systems. Everything is here possible. And of course, we have the advantages of such a system. We have a higher degree of virtualization compared to a dyno test, so we can vary the motor parameter. We have no restrictions, for example, with regards to inertia, and we have no moving parts at all. And compared to a signal level system, we have a greater depth for testing, because now we have the power electronic component in the loop, and we can test the whole power stage as well. So thank you for attending the Innovation Coffee Break on testing of electric drives on power level. I hope you enjoyed it. dSPACE is offering a comprehensive tool chain for testing electric drives and e-mobility. And I'd like to invite you to attend our online workshops and further coffee breaks in the future. Thank you. So now let's see if we have some questions. OK. How can the system be automated is a question. So we have the complete dSPACE toolchain as well as standards that we support. So we can use Automation Desk, as is basically known from our HIL rigs. But we can also use the XIL API to also support third party. Maybe another question. OK, what infrastructure is required for such a system? So basically, the system needs 400 volts to operate. And we have water-cooled setup here for the power density. So we also require the water cooling infrastructure to cool the system. Maybe some words for the power. As we circulate the system power within the system, we only have a small grid connection, because we only need to cover the losses. And another one, can real components be integrated? OK. Real components, as I said, we are only covering the losses. When you use real components as part of the device under test, one has to think about the power flow within the overall system. For example, if you connect a dyno. But this is no problem for our systems, because what we actually have to do in this case is just to design the supply rack in a way to cover all this power consumption from the grid. So it's just a matter of designing the system to your needs. Thank you.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.